Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Munisha Pulikatra here. In this video I will be covering question 4 to question 11 of exercise 1.3 of arithmetic progression. In my previous video I had covered from question 1 to 3, so this is the last exercise of arithmetic progression where there are questions from 1 to up to 20, where in this I will be covering only 4 to 11. So please stay till the end so that you can understand all the concepts clearly. Let us start the session. Coming to the fourth sum of exercise 1.3. So the problem is, how many terms of the AP 9, 17, 25 must be taken to give a sum of 636? That is, SN is given, that is 636. We need to find out on which term we get that value 636. Okay. So the AP given is 9, 17, 25, etc. Here 9 is T1, T2, T3, etc. So the first term A is equal to T1, that is 9. So next common difference D is T2 minus T1, that is 17 minus 9, that is 8. Next SN is given, SN is equal to 636. We need to find out the number of terms. Since only SN is given, we can directly put the SN formula, that is SN is equal to n by 2 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So 636 is equal to, n is not given, so we have to put right as it is, n by 2 into 2 into A, so A is 9, plus n minus 1 into D is 8. Next 636 is equal to n by 2, 2 9s are 18, plus multiply 8 to this whole term, so 8 into n is 8n minus 8, so it will be 636 is equal to n by 2 into 18 minus 8 is 10 plus 8n. Okay, so since we can see here there will be a common term in 10 and 8n, that is 2, since these two numbers are completely divisible by 2. Okay, so in the next step we will take 2 common from here. So when we take 2 common, the remaining will be 5 plus 4n. So here this 2 get cancels each other. Okay, so it will become 636 is equal to n into 5 plus 4n. So next 636 is equal to 5 into n is 5n plus 4n square. Now we have to write it in the form of quadratic equation. So 4n square write as it is, don't shift here, we have to write it as it is, that is 4n square plus 5n. So now we are shifting the 636 to right hand side, it will become minus 636. Okay, so now this is in the form of quadratic equation. So now what we have to do is, we have to factorize it first by multiplying the first and the last term. Okay, 4 and 636. So try multiplying it, that is 636 into 4. So 4 6 are 24, 2 carry, 4 3s are 12, 13 14. So 4 6 are 24 plus 1, 25. It is 2544. Okay. Now we need to split the middle term. Okay. We need to split the middle term such that when two numbers are taken, the addition or subtraction of it should give 5n and the multiplication of those two numbers should give 2544. Right. So in order to find out, first we need to take LCM of this 2544, right? So I will take from 4 1s are, so 4 6 are 24, 1 carry, 4 3s are 12, there will be 2 carry, so 4 6 are 24. Okay, next I will take 3, so 3 2s are 6, 1s are and 2s are. Okay, so next 2 1s are and 2 6 are. Okay, next again I will take 2, 2 5s are, 2 3s are. We can stop here because 53 is a prime number. So we can stop here. Next, we need to check the grouping of it. So 4 3s are 12, 12 2s are 24, and 24 2s are 48. Okay, so we get two numbers, one is 53 and another one is 48. So when we multiply these two numbers, that is 8 3s are 24, 8 5s are 40, 42. Next 4 3s are 12, 4 5s are 20 and 21. So we will get this 2544. Okay, so when we multiply this number, we will get 2544. So when we subtract it, okay, 53 minus 48. So 53 minus 48 is 5. So when we subtract it, we will get this middle term. So this is the two numbers which we need to write here. Okay, first and the last term should be written as it is, that is 4 and square and minus 636 should be written as it is. Instead of the middle term plus 5n, we need to write 53 and 48, such that it should be plus 53n and minus 48n. Okay, why means it is plus 5n, so the larger number should have that positive sign. So plus into minus minus, 53 minus 48 is 5. Okay, next we need to take common of two terms by grouping it. Okay, here only n is common term. 53 and 4 will not be divisible from a single digit, so take n common. When you take n common, the remaining will be 4n plus 53. So next, how we can take common number here means, just check it the first bracket here. In the first bracket, the first term is 4n. So there is a number which divides 48 such that the quotient will be 4. So which is that number? 12. So 12 4s are 48, right? So in this step, you need to check whether the given number is divisible by any other factor or not. Okay, here I am taking minus 12. Since here minus is there, I am taking the same sign, minus 12 common. When I take minus 12 common, so 12 4s are 48. So minus into minus is plus, so plus 4n. And minus into minus is plus. Now it should be 53, right? So now try multiplying it. That is 53 into 12. Okay. So 12 3s are 36. 3 carry. 12 5s are 60. Plus 3 is 636. So it is 53. Okay. So take common outside. That is 4n plus 3 is the first term. Next is n minus 12. We need to equate it separately to 0. So here 4n plus 53 is equal to 0. So 4n is equal to minus 53. N is equal to minus 53 by 4. Okay. The next one is n minus 12 is equal to 0. N is equal to 12. So one thing we have to keep it in mind, this n number of terms n will neither be a fraction nor be a negative number. Okay, it should only be only a positive number. So the answer for number of terms n is 12. So they have asked on which term, how many terms of an AP must be taken to give a sum of 636. So the answer is n is equal to 12. Hope you understood this. Moving on to the fifth problem of this session. Here the first term of an AP is 5, that is the first term is given, A is equal to 5, and the last term is 45. Last term means it can be taken as L or it can be TN. Okay, the last term is 45 and the sum is 400. So SN is 400. We need to find the number of terms, that is N, and common difference, that is D. Okay, since the first and the last term is given, we can directly write the formula as SN is equal to N by 2 into A plus L, that is first and the last term. So SN is given as 400, N we need to find out, so write as it is. Next A is 5 and L is 45. Okay, so 400 is equal to N by 2, 45 plus 5 is 50, so 2 1s are 2, 25s are, so it will be 400 is equal to N into 25. So in the next step, 25 divides 400 is equal to N. So here 5 5s are 5 8s are 40, so it will be 80. So 80 divided by 5 is equal to n. So that is 5 1s are 5, 3 carry, 5 6 are. Okay, so n will be 16. So the number of terms is 16. Okay, next we need to find out, the n is already found out, so we need to find the common difference. For that we can write Tn formula. Tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Tn, that is last term, is 45, a is 5, plus n is 16 minus 1, d we need to find out. So 45, I will shift 5 this side, it will become minus 5. 16 minus 1 is 15d. Okay, so 45 minus 5 is 40 is equal to 15d. So 40 divided by 15 is equal to d. It is 5 3s are and 5 8s are. So the common difference d is equal to 8 by 3. Hope you understood this problem very clearly. Moving on to the sixth problem. The question is, the first and the last term of an AP are 17 and 350 respectively. Okay, so the first term is 17 and the last term, that is Tn, the last term is 350. Okay, if the common difference is 9, the common difference is given, that is 9. So how many terms are there and what is their sum? So we need to find out the number of terms and also the sum of n terms. Okay, so here first we need to find out n, so we need to apply Tn formula. Tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So here Tn is 350 is equal to, a is 17 plus n is not given, so n minus 1 as it is, and d. Okay, d is 9. So next, 350 minus 17 is equal to n minus 1 into 9. So 350 minus 17 is 10 minus 7 is 3 and 4 minus 1 is 3. So this will be 333 is equal to n minus 1 into 9. So next we need to divide 333 by 9. So it will be n minus 1. So 3 3s are 311. So it is 111 divided by 3 is equal to n minus 1. We will try dividing it. So 3 3s are 9. So 2 is remaining, 1. Next, 3 7s are 21. Okay, so 3 37s are. Okay, here quotient is 37 is equal to n minus 1. In the next step, we need to shift 1 to left hand side. It will become plus 1. So n is 38. Okay, so n is equal to 38. So this is the value of n. So next we need to find out Sn. Since first and last term is given, we can apply this smaller formula, that is n by 2 into a plus l. L is the last term. So Sn, instead of n we can write it as 38 is equal to, n is 38 divided by 2 into a is 17 plus l is 350. Okay, so S38 is equal to 2 1s are 2, 19s are. So 19 into, we need to add 350 plus 17. So it will be 367. So next we need to multiply 367 into 19. So 9 7s are 63, 6 carry, 9 6s are 54 plus 6 is 60, 9 3s are 27, 27 plus 6 is 33. Next, 1 into 367 is 367. Okay, the answer is 3796, that is 6973. So the sum of 38 terms is equal to 6973. So hope you understood this problem. coming to the seventh problem of this session. So the seventh problem is find the sum of first 22 terms of an AP. So they have asked to find the sum. So S, find the sum of first 22, that is S22 we need to find out. Okay, so find the sum of first 22 terms of an AP in which D is equal to 7, that is common difference is given, that is 7, and then 22nd term is 149. It is term, not sum, therefore T22 is equal to 149. So these are the informations which they are given. We need to find out S22. Okay, since they have given T22, we need to apply TN formula first. So TN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D, in which they have given T22 is equal to, A is not given, so write as it is, N is 22 minus 1 into D is 7. So the value for T22 is 149 is equal to A plus 22 minus 1 is 21 into 7. So 149 is equal to A plus 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14, that is 147. So in the next step, I will shift 147 to left hand side. So it will become minus 147. So 149 minus 147 is 2. So the first term A is equal to 2 here. So since we get 2 and D is there, we need to find out S22. So we can directly take the smaller formula itself. N by 2 into A plus L or A plus TN. Okay. Since N is same both sides. So S22 is equal to 22 by 2 into A is 2 plus TN will be T22. Okay. So T22. So S22 is equal to, here 2 ones are 2 elevens are 11 into 2 plus T22 is 149. Okay. So S22 is equal to 11 into 149 plus 2 is 151. Here we need to multiply 151 into 11. Okay. So it will be 151. It will become 1661. Okay. The sum of 22 terms is equal to 166 and 1. Hope you understood the problem well. Moving on to the 8th problem. So the 8th one is find the sum of first 51 terms of an AP. Okay, find the sum of first 51 terms means we need to find S51. So since it is S51, the N will be 51 here. Okay, so the find the sum of first 51 terms of an AP whose second and third term, that is second term and third term, second and third term are 14 and 18 respectively. Okay, they have given two different terms and S51 we need to find out. So first, here A is not given and common difference D is also not given. Since we know what is common difference, what do you mean by common difference? It can be previous term by the next term, that is T2 minus T1, or it can be T3 minus T2, okay, it can be T4 minus T3, right, the previous term to the next term, so etc. So here they have given T3 and T2. Since they have given T3 and T2, we can directly find out the common difference, right, we can directly find out the common difference here. So D is equal to T3 minus T2. So the value of T3 is 18 minus T2 is 14. So 18 minus 14 is 4. So the common difference here is 4. So after getting common difference, you can substitute this common difference to one of the two equation. Okay, I will be taking second equation, that is T2 is equal to 14. By applying TN formula, TN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Here T2 is equal to A plus N is 2 minus 1 into D is 4. T2 value is 14 is equal to A plus 1 into 4. In the next step, 14 minus 4 is equal to A. So 14 minus 4 is 10. So A is equal to 10. So we got both first term A and common difference D. Okay? So after getting this, what we need to find out? S51. So apply SN formula. SN is equal to N by 2, 2A plus N minus 1 into D. Okay? See here, in this case, we can't write that SN is equal to N by 2 into A plus L formula. If we need to write that, then the N should be same. N of this SN and the N of this term should be same. Here it varies. In this case, we can't write those formula. Okay? So S51 is equal to 51 by 2 into 2A. So 2 into 10 plus N is 51 minus 1 into D is 4. Okay? So next, 51 by 2 into 2 into 10 is 20 plus 51 minus 1 is 50 into 4. Okay? So 51 by 2 into 20 plus, so 5 fourths are 20. So 50 into 4 is 200. Okay? So it will become 51 by 2 into 200 plus 20 is 220. So we can divide it. 110 is a. So we need to multiply 110 into 51 here. Okay? So 500, 51s and 51s. So it will become 5610. Okay? The sum of 51 term is equal to 5610. Hope you understood this problem properly. Moving on to the ninth question. The ninth question is, if the sum of first 7 terms of an AP is 49, okay? They are given the sum of 7 terms. The sum of 7 terms is 49 and that of 17 term, that is the sum of 17 term is equal to 289, okay? This is the only information they have given, where we need to find out SN. So there is no N term here. We need to find out plainly SN, okay? So first, since they have given only S, we need to write SN formula. SN is equal to N by 2, 2A plus N minus 1 into D. For this, we need to substitute both the equations one after the other. That is, first in case, we need to take S7, first case. S7 is equal to, this is 7 by 2 into 2 into A. Plus N is 7, 7 minus 1 into D is not given, so write as it is. So S7 is 49 here. 49 is equal to 7 by 2 into 2A plus 7 minus 1 is 6D. Here 49 is equal to 7 by 2. Here both the digits are divisible by 2, so I am taking 2 common here. So the remaining terms will be A plus 2 3s are 6, so A plus 3D. Here 2 get cancels each other. Next, 49 is equal to 7 into A plus 3D. Here 7 1s are 7, 7s are 49. So the equation will be 7 is equal to A plus 3D. Okay, so this is the first equation, that is 7 is equal to A plus 3D. This is the first equation, okay? Next, we need to substitute second equation to SN formula. So it will become S17 is equal to 17 by 2 into 2A plus 17 minus 1 into D. So S17 is 289 is equal to 17 by 2 into 2A plus 16D. So 289 is equal to 17 by 2. Here in both the terms are divisible by 2. So I am taking 2 common here. So the remaining will be A plus 8D. Here 2 get cancels each other. So 289 is equal to 17 into A plus 8D. Here 17 ones are 17, 17s are. How means 17 square is equal to 289. Okay, so that is 17 into 17 is 289. Okay, so the equation will become 17 is equal to A plus 8D. So this is the second equation. Okay, so after getting two equations, we need to solve it. So solve equation 1 and 2. Okay, the first equation is a plus 3d is equal to 7. The second equation is a plus 8d is equal to 17. So we need to change the sign. After changing the sign, we can see here plus a minus a get cancels each other. Remaining plus into minus is minus. So 8 minus 3 is 5d. Larger number is 8. So the sign negative retains here. Next, plus into minus minus. 17 minus 7 is 10. Larger number is 17 and the 17 has negative sign. Okay, minus here. Minus and minus get cancels each other. So d is equal to 10 divided by 5. Here 5 ones are, 5 twos are. Okay, so the common difference d is 2. So after getting the common difference, we need to substitute this common difference either to first equation or second equation. So I will be taking equation 1 here. So equation 1 is 7 is equal to a plus 3d. So 7 is equal to a plus 3 into 2. So 7, 3 twos are 6. So a plus 6. 7 minus 6 is equal to a. Here a will be 1. Okay, so we got a and d value. Here we need to find out sn. So directly write sn formula. So sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So there is no value for n since we need to find out sn itself. So write sn is equal to n by 2. 2 into a is 1 plus n minus 1 as it is and d is 2. Okay, so sn is equal to n by 2 into 2 into 1 is 2 plus multiply 2 to this whole term, it will become 2n minus 2 ones are 2. So here minus 2 and plus 2 get cancels each other. So remaining is sn is equal to n by 2 into 2n. Okay, here 2 2 get cancels each other. So the remaining is sn is equal to n into n. N into n is n square. So the value for sn is n square. So this is the method of doing this problem. Hope you understood this. In 10th sum, there are two sub questions. One is tn is equal to 3 plus 4n and the second one is tn is equal to 9 minus 5n. Okay, here first we need to find out an AP sequence, and after finding out the AP sequence from the given two equations, sub questions, we need to find the sum of 15 terms. Okay, first I will do the first sum here. The first one is tn is equal to 3 plus 4n. We need to substitute value for n here. So in the first case, I will put n is equal to 1. So it will become 3 plus 4 into 1, that is 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. Next, t2 is equal to 3 plus 4 into 2, that is 3 plus 4 twos are 8, so it will be 11. Next, t3 is equal to 3 plus 4 into 3, that is 3 plus 4 threes are 12. This is 15. So three terms is enough for this. Later we need to find out the common difference. Okay, so the common difference is d is equal to, in the first case, t2 minus t1. So t2 minus t1 is 11 minus 7. 11 minus 7 is 4. Next, d is equal to T3 minus T2. So T3 minus T2 is 15 minus 11. That is also 4. Okay. So since common difference is constant, the given numbers are in, the numbers which we obtain are in AP. Okay. Therefore, the sequence is in AP. Okay, write the sequence here. First one is 7, 11, 15, etc. Okay, here we need to find out the sum of 15 terms. We need to find the sum of 15 terms. Okay, now find out A. A is equal to first term 7. D, we have already calculated that D is equal to 4. Next, N. S 15, therefore N is equal to 15. We need to find SN, sorry, that is S 15. Okay, S 15. So we need to write the formula of SN here. SN is equal to N by 2, 2A plus N minus 1 into D. Here S 15 is equal to 15 by 2 into 2 into A is 7 plus N is 15, 15 minus 1 into D is 4. Okay, so 15 divided by 2 into 2 sevens are 14 plus 15 minus 1 is 14 into 4. So 15 divided by 2 into 14 plus 14 fours are 56. Okay, so 15 divided by 2 into 56 plus 14 is 70. Next we need to divide it. 2 ones are 235s are. So 15 into 35. 5 5s are 25, 2 carry, 5 1s are 5, 6 7. So 3 5s are 15, 1 carry, 3 1s are 3, 4. Okay, so it will be 5, 7 plus 5 is 12, and 1 carry, 5. So 525. So the sum of 15 terms is equal to 525. So this is the answer for the first question, that is TN is equal to 3 plus 4, and we need to do the second question also. So the second sub question of 10th one is TN is equal to 9 minus 51. Like the first one itself, we need to do this. So first we need to take N as 1. So T1 is equal to 9 minus 5 into 1 is equal to 9 minus 5 ones are 5. So 9 minus 5 is 4. Next, take N is equal to 2. So T2, 9 minus 5 into 2, it will be 9 minus 5 2s are 10. It will become minus 1, that is 10 minus 9, minus 1. Next, T3 is equal to 9 minus 5 into 3, that is 9 minus 15. So 15 minus 9 is minus 6. Since larger number has negative sign, the negative sign should be retained here. So first three terms are enough. Next we need to find out the common difference. So D is equal to T2 minus T1. T2 is minus 1 minus T1 is 4. So minus into minus plus, the common difference is minus 5. In the second case, D is equal to T3 minus T2. T3 is minus 6. T2 is already minus 1. So we need to put a bracket here, minus 1. So it will become minus 6 plus 1, that is minus 5. Okay, here the common difference is constant. So since the common difference is constant, these terms are in AP. Okay, so AP is 4, minus 1, minus 6, etc. Here A will be the first term, A is 4, and D is the common difference which we already calculated, that is minus 5. And since we need to find out the 15 terms, S 15, we need to find 15 terms, so N will become 15. Okay, so we need to apply SN formula. SN is equal to N by 2, 2A plus N minus 1 into D. So S 15 is equal to 15 by 2 into 2 into A is 4 plus N is 15, 15 minus 1, and D is minus 5. Okay, since 15 is not divisible by 2, we can write it as it is. So 2 4s are 8 plus 15 minus 1 is 14 into minus 5. So 15 by 2 into 8 plus, so we can write plus into minus. So plus into minus is minus. So 14 5 is a 70. So it will become 15 by 2 into 70 minus 8 is 62. The larger number has a sign minus, so we should retain here. So next divide, 2 1s are 2, 30 1s are. Okay. So here it will be 15 into minus 31. Okay, we need to multiply 15 into minus 31. So 15 1s are 15, 1 carry, 15 3s are 45 plus 1, 46. Okay. So the sum of 15 terms is equal to minus 465, since here is a minus. Okay. This is the way of doing this problem. Hope you understood this. So this is the last question of this session, 11th one. So here they have given Sn. That is, if the sum of the first n terms of an AP is 4n square minus n square. That is, they have given Sn. Sn as 4n square, 4n minus n square. Okay, we need to concentrate this sum properly, because there are some sort of confusions. Okay, I will tell you. Next, what they have asked, what is the first term? Here only in this question they have mentioned first term as S1. Okay, so in order to find that first term, we need to substitute 1 in the place of S1. Okay, so S1 is equal to 4 into 1 minus 1 square. So it will be 4 minus 1, that is 3. So S1 is equal to 3. Next they have asked, what is the sum of first two terms? Okay, sum of first two terms means, that is S2, because S2 is equal to sum of first two terms. So sum of first two terms is also equal to S2. So for this we can directly substitute 2 in the place of this Sn. Okay, so I'll be substituting it, 4 into 2 minus 2 square. Okay, so 4 2s are 8 minus 2 square is 4. It will be 8 minus 4, 4. Okay, we got two equations. One is S1 for the sum and the one is S2. Next question is, what is the second term? They have asked second term. Only for the first term they have mentioned it is S1. Okay, now they have they are asking what is the second term. So second term is T2. In my introductory part, in the introductory part of arithmetic progression, I have told you one formula, that is Tn is also equal to Sn minus Sn minus 1. If you gone through that video properly, you might have remember this formula. Okay, here they have told to find out T2. So instead of n, we need to apply 2 here. Okay, we need to substitute 2. So T2 is equal to S2 minus S2 minus 1. So n minus 1, that is 2 minus 1. Okay, it will become S2 minus S1. So here T2 is equal to S2 minus S1. S2 we have already found out, that is 4, minus S1 is also, the value for S1 we already have, that is 3. So 4 minus 3. So T2 is equal to 4 minus 3, that is 1. Okay. So what are the informations we got? What are the solutions we got here? We got S1, we got the sum of the first two terms, and we got the second term. Okay. Next we need to find out the third, tenth and the nth term. Okay. For this, first I will directly find out the nth term, nth equation first. For that we need to write Tn formula, that is a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay, so Tn is equal to a. What is a? A means first term, right? So here the first term is mentioned as s, s1. This is also equal to a. So instead of a, we can write it as 3 plus n minus 1 into d. We need d here. So what is d? Common difference. So common difference is t2 minus t1. Okay, so common difference is previous term to the first term, right? So here t2 is there, t2 we have already found out, that is t2 is 1 minus t1 is first term. So t1 is first term, which is also equal to 3. Okay, so 3. So d is equal to 1 minus 3 is minus 2. Okay, instead of d we can write it as minus 2. So tn is equal to 3. Here we need to multiply, n into minus 2 is minus 2n, minus into minus plus 2 into 1 is 2. Okay, the nth term equation is given by, so 3 plus 2 is 5 minus 2n. So this is the equation for the nth term. Okay, this is the equation for the nth term. Now we need to find out third and the tenth term. So third term, directly put 3 in the place of n here. The equation is, nth term is tn is equal to 5 minus 2n. We need to find out t3. So 5 minus 2 into 3. So we will get 5 minus 2, 3 is a 6, that is minus 1. So this is the value for t3. So next what we need to find out, that is t10. Again, we need to write the nth formula. Okay, so next t10, that is 5 minus 2 into 10, that is 5 minus 20, that will be equal to t10 is equal to minus 15. Fine. So we get the value for s1. So first answer is s1. So s1 is 3. So next, the sum of first two terms, the sum of first two terms is s2, that is 4. Next, the third question they have asked is the second term is t2, that is equal to 1. Then they have asked third term, that is t3, so t3 is minus 1. Next is 10th term, that is t10, so t10 is minus 15. So last they have asked nth term, that is tn, so tn is given by 5 minus 2n. So this is the way of solving this equation. Hope you understood this. So this is the last question. I hope from 4th to 11th question you have understood how to do the problems in the same concept. They can give you some for 4 marks AP problem will be there, which will be very important. So please practice it daily. So without practicing you can't do well in your board exam. So maths, we will get to know about maths only when we practice, practice and practice. Okay, thank you.